Dear students, next topic is methods of improving input impedance. So already we discussed in unit 1, that is the comparison of three configuration, common base, common emitter and common collector. So according to this comparison, we can set that common collector or emitter follower has the high input impedance. A single stage emitter follower circuit can give input impedance up to 500 kilo-ohm. So single stage can give 500 kilo-ohm, which is very high when compared to common base and common emitter configuration. So if we can connect the multi-stage common collector amplifier, means it will give a high input impedance, that is called the improving input impedance, right? So the input impedance of this circuit can be improved by direct coupling of two stages of emitter follower circuits, which is called the Darlington amplifier. So Darlington amplifier is nothing but the input impedance of this circuit can be improved. For that we can coupling the two stages of emitter follower circuits. So these are the techniques which has been used to improve the input impedance. One is Darlington amplifier, bootstrap technique, bootstrap Darlington amplifier. So this portion is common collector amplifier circuit, so which is directly coupling with another one common collector amplifier circuit. So the cascade of common collector amplifier is called as the Darlington amplifier. So from the diagram we can assume these two conditions, one is RL HOE less than 0.1 and RL to HOE greater than 0.1. So first we have to analyze this second stage. So in this second stage we just draw the HPT model for this second stage transistor. So it can be like this, right? So normally this is the hybrid pi model, that is the input, the transistor input side is HIE and output side is HFEIB and one more resistance, emitter resistance, which is connected in this here, right? So this arrow mark is replaced as this direction. So in that redrawn diagram we can modify this circuit into like this. So the emitter's resistance is parallel with this current source, right? From that circuit we can find the current gain. So AI2 equal to I0 divided by IB, output divided by input. So I0 is nothing but minus IE divided by IB. So IE equal to IB plus HFEIB divided by IB. So IB common, so 1 plus HFE, IB cancel. So AI2 equal to 1 plus HFE. Then input resistance, or I equal to V2 divided by IB2. So apply the KVL at the input side. So we get V2 minus IB2 HIE minus IORE, right? This is the voltage. This one is current, so we can't take this parameter. So V2 minus IB2 HIE minus I0RE. So V2 equal to IB2 HIE plus I0RE. So RI2 equal to V2 by IB2. So this is divided by IB2. So IB2 IB2 cancel. So HIE plus I0 by IB2 into RE. So HIE I0 IB2 is nothing but AI2. So RI2 equal to 1 plus HFE into RI. AI2 is 1 plus HFE. This HIE value is very small, so we can neglect this one. So AI2 is nothing but 1 plus HFE into RE. Then analysis of first stage. This is the hybrid pi model for the first transistor common collector circuit, right? So from that first stage diagram we can find the current gain IB2 by IB1. IB2 is nothing but minus IE1 by IB1. So IE1 is nothing but sum of base current and collector current. So apply the KCL, we get IC1. So HFEIB1 HOEVC1. HFEIB1 plus HOEVC is nothing but I into R minus IB2 into RL1. So here IB2 is nothing but IE1. So HFEIB1 plus HOEIE1 into RL1. IE1 equal to minus IB1 plus, IE1 equal to IB1 plus IC1. So this IB1, this minus sign, then IC1 is this term. So substitute this term. So from we can consider IE1 is a one side and the remaining current is the another side. So IE1 plus HOEIE1 RL1 equal to minus IB1 minus HFEIB1. So here IE1 is commonly taken, here IB1 is commonly taken. So our record formula is IE1 by IB1. So IE1 by IB1 equal to 1 plus HFE divided by 1 plus HFE RL1. So here RL1 equal to 1 plus HFE into RE. So HFE value less than greater than 1. so we can neglect the HFE 1 value. So 1 plus HFE divided by 1 plus HOE. RL1 is already we derived 1 plus HFE RIE. So we can aggregate this 1 value. So remaining HFE RIE. Then input resistance VI by IB1. So apply KVL at the input loop. IB HIE plus HRE VC1 plus IB2 RL2. This value is very small. So we can neglect this one. So divided by IB1. So here HIE IB2 by IB1 RL1. Which is nothing but AI1. AI1 is nothing but HIE plus 1 plus HFE, RL1 is nothing but 1 plus HFE RIE. So AI1 is nothing but 1 plus HFE divided by 1 plus HOE HFE RE. So here HIE value is less than this term. So we can neglect the HIE value also. So RI1 equal to 1 plus HFE the whole squared into RE divided by 1 plus HOE HFE RE. So the overall input resistance, overall current gain AI equal to the stage 1 current gain into stage 2 current gain. So multiply, we can get this answer. So this is the parameter input resistance for single stage. This is already we derived in the unit 1, and current gain also we derived in unit 1 for single stage of common collector amplifier. But origin is nothing but direct coupling of common collector, that is more than two common collector amplifier. So here RA value is this one and AI value this one. So when compared to this, this value is very high. That is the input impedance is very high because it comes in terms of the square. For example, 500 kilo ohm means here 500 square kilo ohm, so it should be very high. So then overall voltage gain AV equal to 1 minus HIE RI2 and output impedance R02 equal to HIE plus RS2 divided by 1 plus HFE the whole square plus HIE divided by 1 plus HFE. So we combine the both output resistance, that is stage 1 and stage 2. So this is the advantages of Darlington amplifier. It improves the current gain and input resistance. More than two stages to improve the input impedance is impossible because the transistors are identical. If two stages enough for improving the input impedance. If more than two stages, now it's not possible because the transistors are identical. Because IC is equal to beta IB for one stage. If IC is equal to 1 plus HFE power N into IB N stage, so it's not possible for getting the higher input impedance. So anyway, we can use two common collector amplifier which has been increased the input impedance. So this N stages which require the power amplifier to handle large output, because here N number stages, so it requires a more number of power, but power amplifier is not used in a amplifier circuits. So the leakage current of first transistor is amplified by the second transistor, so overall leakage current become high. So these are the drawback in a Darlington amplifier. So the first drawback is it can be used only in a two stages. The reason is more than two stages means it requires a more number of power. So but in an amplifier circuit, we are not using a power amplifier. This is one disadvantage. Another one is the leakage current become high, overall leakage current. Because the leakage current in a first transistor is amplified, it given to the second amplifier, second stage. So the output, finally that output having a overall leakage current which become a high. Okay, so that's all about the Darlington amplifier.